हेलो क्लास 8, लेट्स कंटिन्यू चैप्टर 3, एलिमेंट्स कंपाउंड्स एंड मिक्सचर। इन प्रीवियस वीडियो वी डिस्कस्ड अबाउट द प्योर सब्सटेंसेस, दे आर क्लासिफाइड इनटू एलिमेंट्स एंड कंपाउंड्स एंड इम्प्योर सब्सटेंसेस एज मिक्सचर्स। एंड एलिमेंट्स आर व्हाट क्लासिफाइड इनटू मैटर्स, नॉन मैटर्स, मेटलॉइड्स एंड नोबल गैसेस। Right now in this video we will discuss about the molecules and atomicity. Now what is molecule? Molecules actually it is atom of the same element or different element combined to form a molecule. It is the smallest particle of a substance which can normally exist independently and can retain the physical and chemical properties of the substance. For example, this hydrogen. At one atom of hydrogen when combined with another atom of same atom of hydrogen, same element of hydrogen, it gives you one molecule of hydrogen. Right? The same way when one atom of oxygen combined with another atom of oxygen, it gives one molecule of oxygen. Right? These are what? Atoms of same element combined to give molecule. But sometimes atoms of different element, they combine and they give what? Molecules of compound or hydrogen chloride. Right? One molecule of hydrogen chloride is made up of one atom of hydrogen and one atom of chlorine. Right? Now next is your atomicity. What is atomicity? It is the number of atoms of an element that join together forming a molecule of that element is known as atomicity. Now what is saying? Number of atoms of an element that join together forming a molecule. For example, what is the atomicity of hydrogen here? 2. Why? Because 2 atoms of hydrogen combine to form one molecule of hydrogen. The same way, what is the atomicity of oxygen? 2 atoms of oxygen combine to form one molecule of oxygen, so its atomicity is 2. So what is atomicity? Number of atoms of an element that join together forming a molecule of that element is known as atomicity. Okay, now next is your atoms of the same element forming a molecule. Elements made up of single atom, they are called monoatomic molecules. And examples are all matters and all noble gases. They are monoatomic molecules. Right? Now, next is your diatomic molecules. If they are the molecules which contain 2 atoms of same type. For example, H2. Its atomicity is 2 and it is diatomic molecule. Oxygen is also diatomic molecule. Nitrogen is also diatomic molecule. Now, next is your elements made up of more than 2 atoms. Then they are called polyatomic molecules. And they can means polyatomic molecules means which contain more than 3 atoms of the same type. For example, ozone. In ozone, just look at here. Ozone is made up of 3 atoms of oxygen and form ozone molecule, that is your what? O3. Right? Okay, now just look at here. Hydrogen one molecule of hydrogen is made up of 2 atoms of hydrogen. So, its atomicity is 2. Oxygen atomicity is also 2. Chlorine atomicity is also 2. Bromine atomicity is also 2. Iodine atomicity is also 2. But atomicity of oxygen is 3. And atomicity of phosphorus is 4. Right? So it is these 2 are polyatomic. Which one? Ozone and phosphorus are polyatomic molecules. While rest hydrogen to iodine, they are diatomic molecule. Now next is your atoms of different elements forming a molecule or compound. Okay, molecules of animals containing two or more atoms of different kinds chemically combined together are called molecules of compounds. For example, when two atoms of hydrogen combined with one atom of oxygen, it gives one molecule of water, and water is a compound. Same way, when carbon dioxide, one atom of carbon and two atom of oxygen combined to give one molecule of carbon dioxide, means here atoms of different elements, they combined and they form molecule of a compound, right? Okay, now next is your compounds. Now, what is compound? A compound is a pure substance made up of two or more elements or atoms of different elements combined chemically in a fixed proportion or fixed ratio. For example, water molecule is water is a compound, and it's one molecule of water is made up of what? Two atoms of hydrogen when combined in a fixed proportion with one atom of oxygen. Right, and they give one molecule of water. Same way, just look at here, carbon dioxide, sodium chloride, hydrogen chloride, nitric acid, iron sulfide, these are what? All compounds. Right, now what are the characteristics of compounds? Components in a compound are in a definite proportion. What are components? For example, in water, what are the components of water? Hydrogen and oxygen are the what components of water, right? So they are always in definite proportion or fixed proportion. Next is your compound is always homogeneous. Homogeneous means they have identical composition. Means in water, if you just see one glass of water, You will not find any hydrogen atom or oxygen atom separately, right? Here the components, they are mixed together in such a way that they become identical, they become same, right? Now next is your particles in a compound are of one kind. Next is your compounds have a definite set of properties. Means the water which you take from any place, it has always same properties. Now, elements in the compound do not retain their original properties. Means water is made up of two atom of hydrogen, and hydrogen is a highly inflammable gas, while oxygen is a what? It support burning. Hydrogen gas burns and oxygen support burning, but when these two atoms combine in a fixed proportion, then they form a water molecule, and water always puts off the fire or extinguishes the fire. Means the properties of elements do not retain their original properties in a compound. And next is your but components in a compound can be separated by chemical means only. You cannot separate out this hydrogen and oxygen from water molecule by physical means. You can separate out them only by chemical means, right? Next is your, okay, for just example, even iron mixed with sulfur in a fixed proportion, right, you get iron sulfide. But now, can you separate out this iron from this iron sulfide by using magnet? No, right? But if you take a mixture of iron and sulfur, right, in any proportion, when you are just simply mixing iron and sulfur, then you can easily separate out this iron from this mixture by using magnet, right?